Wait, hold on, hold on, hold on. Why does she kind of look a bit older? Or am I just blind? Am I just blind and tired? He kind of looked older here. His voice is also... Huh? Is he aging? Like, is he going in circus and aging? Huh? Yeah, he looks like an old man. What? Yeah, he's all wrinkled and... Yeah, he's aging, huh? Not sure what to make of it. Like, what if the more they try to go down, the more they age? Because if they just keep going and keep aging and keep going and keep aging, you know, like the people entering the hotel, maybe that's how they died, actually. Because they tried to exit and they just kept aging and aging and aging and maybe they died. I have no idea what's going on, but okay. Okay, let's go back to the outro. Yeah, see, this image is kind of what is happening. Like, they just keep going in circles with the stairs. They think they are going up, but they're actually going down. And they just keep on ending in the same spot. I guess maybe this is like a time loop devil of sorts that is doing these things. Also, Boomas? I just paused and I'm saying Boomas! Boomas everywhere! Wait. Yeah, I don't have the capacity to do like a whole analysis, but this is like the Michelangelo sculpture, right? Bro, these people are cultured. And because this kind of also looks like the... Yeah, it kind of looks like the Sistine Chapel from the Vatican. Bro, people of culture, you love to see it, people of culture. I bet they're already the Twitter threads analyzing the images. Wait, I keep going back because there are things... Also, the fact that she is Mary and he is Jesus in this painting, is it trying to imply that he will sacrifice himself for mommy? I mean, not that Jesus sacrifices himself for mommy because he's basically murdered, but he sacrifices himself for humanity, so... I mean, it would be a weird Jesus, that's for sure. Denji, yeah, he doesn't seem to be very heroic at this moment. He does have noble feelings. He says he saves people for the boobas, for the feelings, but he does care. He does care about helping others. Like, he's just good-natured. And one thing I would say about Denji is that I guess the fact... I would usually be bothered by protagonists who are so obsessed with the female body. But I think in his case, it's just that he never touches women without consent. So I think that's what makes him so likable. Even though he behaves like a brat and he just has this very simplistic ideals, is the fact that he does never touch anyone without consent and he knows his place. So yeah, he's horny, but he's not a perv. I know this because there was a Pokemon card in that design and it has a name. What's it called? Oh, the Esker? Esker stance? Oh, the lithograph. The relativity lithograph by the Dutch artist M.C. So that's... Is this what the whole hotel is? The relativity? Yo. I love how I found out the name of what I was thinking about by thinking of Pokemon. I have a second channel. I have a Twitter account. I have stuff, so... You know, if you want, just go follow me everywhere, read my thoughts, see my other videos, you know, just saying. There's a lot of unpack here because we have people interested in art, films, paintings, sculptures, so many symbolisms, which I probably either don't get or get them wrong. And again, the episodes continue the same path of finding more about certain characters. Like, we had the Power episode, we have the Aki episode, now we have the Himeno episode. Although, we don't know that much about her still, just the fact she lost a lot of people in her life. And Aki, we've seen little Aki losing his whole family. Something we knew about because he mentioned it, but also he was kind of a dick as a child. He was really annoying. That's why I probably kind of, you know, my brain kind of shut off, because I don't like it when I see kids behaving like brats, so I didn't even pay attention that much. Also, the fact that they're basically blaming the Gun Devil on America and tying it with the World Trade Center terrorist attacks. So it kind of takes elements from our existence, like tragedies, and makes statements about guns and gun controls and how they should be tighter and became tighter. And yeah, it is a critique of the society, because devils exist because people allow them to. Now they are just trapped in this hotel, which is interesting. Well, because the guy seems to have been aging. What kind of devil has this power if it's not the Gun Devil? Because they did say that the reaction from the bullet was not strong enough to suggest that it was the Gun Devil. But what if it's the Gun Devil and it's just hiding in plain sight? Because since they are just stuck on the same floor, and they cannot reach the Gun Devil, they wouldn't know if it is the Gun Devil, because their reaction would always be kind of weak. And the more I watch this, the more I like it. Especially because this episode kind of got me thinking a lot. It's funny, because I was so tired. I even thought about postponing the watch, because I was so tired. And then I felt awoken. I think it's cool to experience the anime without actually knowing the story. I wonder if manga readers would like to see the anime as if they didn't know anything that happened or will happen. And probably even after the show will end, I will probably just read the manga until the end point of the anime, because it looks so nice that I don't want to be spoiled. I think, yeah, let's wrap it up, because I've been talking way too much. Yeah, thank you all so much for watching. As always, like, share, subscribe, comment, watch my other videos. I have a bunch. Yeah, I've already made 4. This will be the 5th. I have the Pokemon videos. We are working. I have some more stuff in the works. I'm also planning on starting some other anime and commenting. So your support will be needed and appreciated so that I can keep doing this. I will see you all in the next episode. Bye!